Okay, you fans, some military history, popular culture, and just regular old history. Here you go. I found the Patton, General Patton's family plot, and this wonderful Celtic cross here. Beautiful. This cenotaph to the family. And it says Patton, and there's a prayer from Psalm 15. It says, Lord, who shall dwell in thy tabernacle? Or who shall rest upon thy holy hill? Even he that leadeth an uncorrupt life, and doeth the thing which is right, and speaketh the truth from his heart. Okay, well, let's start off with the family of Georgie. Here was a sister who was 2 years younger than him, Annie. She never married. She lived in the house on Patton Road from 1910, right after it was built, with her father and mother, and she was 23 in 1910, and she died alone there in 1971. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. And here is George Smith Patton. This is the father of Georgie Patton, the general commanding 3rd Army in World War II. And he was born in Charleston, Virginia, September 30th, 1866, right after the Civil War. I'm sorry, 1856. And he died in that house, Lake Vineyard, June 10th, 1927. And here's the mother, Ruth Wilson. She was born in the house that they tore down in 1910 while Georgie was at West Point. That's her birthplace, and she died there in that house like people did back then. 1861 to 1928, Ruth Wilson, the daughter of Benjamin Davis Wilson, the second mayor of Los Angeles, or rather affectionately known by his Hispanic workers as Don Benito. And then here is the Cenotaph Memorial for the greatest general of World War II, in my opinion, the liberator, George S. Patton Jr. He was junior, his grandfather was senior, and his father was George S. Patton the second. And George Patton Jr., he had a son who was the fourth. And he's buried in Ham, Luxembourg, with his men who died during those horrific battles storming across northern France. And this Cenotaph Memorial, Cenotaph was dedicated by the Huntington Westerners, I guess a fraternal organization, in 1997. And this is as close as we're going to get without going to his grave, his memorial, his true resting place. But at least the memory is here of him without going to Luxembourg. Okay, well, and get a load of that cenotaph, that obelisk, Egyptian obelisk. That's the gravestone of Don Benito, who gave his name to Mount Wilson here in Los Angeles. Here he is, B.D. Wilson, and born in Tennessee, came in the 1840s to California, died at Lake Vineyard. And when he died, he gave that land to his daughter Ruth and her husband George. And then when the taxes got really, really prohibitive in the 20s, he sold everything off except the 13 acres that was George Patton, The second he sold all the original 2,000 acres that Don Benito willed to him and Ruth. And Georgie grew up in such a wonderful setting, fantastic. And this, in fact, this is the graveyard adjacent to the church where George Patton Jr., his parents, Ruth, and George Patton II were married. And this is the graveyard, like I said, adjacent to the church, the Our Savior Episcopalian Church, where George, little Georgie, and his family came to church every Sunday throughout his youth. And this right here is Margaret, the mother of Ruth, the second wife of Don Benito. And then this was one of their daughters, Annie. And he was actually married to Ramona Yorba, who died in 1849. That was his first wife, and I thought he had one daughter, that was Maria de Jesus, but apparently right here, there's a son, John Wilson, but I couldn't find it in the family tree. It says Benjamin Davis and Ramona Wilson, son of John B. Wilson. So, like I said, it just said that he had a daughter, and that would have been Maria de Jesus, who was married to a Mr. Shorb. And he was willed some land adjacent to the land that he gave to Ruth and George Patton II, and he named it San Marino after his family plantation in Maryland. That was Mr. Shorb. And these are just extended family right here. I guess maybe family of Margaret, the second wife. And then here's some more family members right here. The Glazels, Patton, I saw these names pop up. And, okay, well, the reason why George Patton Jr., he went into the cavalry originally, which extrapolated into the armored divisions of World War II, is because their father, his father, George Patton Sr., he was a colonel in Virginia in the Civil War, and his brother was also killed. He was a colonel. He was killed at Gettysburg. So they were friends of Colonel Mosby of Mosby's Rangers fame, and as he would visit throughout. At the house at Lake Vineyard where Georgie grew up, that's he was the one who encouraged George Jr. that when he went to West Point to join the cavalry when he got out of West Point. Okay, so let's go to the statue, the memorial statue to General George Patton, the commanding general of the Third Army, and we'll film that and say a few more words about this great general who was very well read. He was dyslexic, as he had a problem reading, so he would memorize long passages from the histories of the Roman military battles, and he was just, he had such a photographic memory that whenever he even did speeches to his men of the Third Army, he would just say them off the cuff extemporaneously from memory. And that was a trait that he developed as a very young boy growing up here in what once was the land owned by his grandfather and his father. And here's a picture, for what it's worth, of Don Benito right here. He died in 1878, and he died I guess 7 years before Georgie was born. Here he is, the famous man, the second mayor of Los Angeles. And in fact, he called his home up there on Patton Court Lake Vineyard because he grew acres and acres of vineyards to grow wine. I mean, to make wine. And then he went to Mount Wilson is because he originally was looking for wood for his wine cask, and when he got up there, he found out that it was very not very good wood for wine fermentation. And so that's where they got the name of Mount Wilson. And okay, well, another family that had a lot to do with the founding of this whole area, Southern California. And okay, well, let's go to the statue, and also in the church where Georgie attended Mass every Sunday throughout his youth. His family, after he died in 1945, they dedicated stained glass windows to all his divisions on the windows surrounding the church. So maybe we can get a shot of that. But then again, there's a Mass going on right now. And this church is Our Savior Episcopalian Church, where it was actually built in 1867, probably built by Don Benito himself. So, okay, well, let me take a shot here of Ramona Yorba. That was Don Benito's first wife, who he, like I said, he had a daughter named Maria de Jesus with. And then she apparently, from that right there, that monument right there, that cenotaph, it says John Wilson, son of Ramona and Benjamin Davis. So you know what, I'm sorry, that wasn't Ramona, that picture. That was, I guess, the daughter. That was Maria. Yeah, because she married Mr. Shorb, Ramona Yorba Shorb. Okay, well, I thought her name was Ramona, but okay, well, I stand corrected, and I apologize. That photo looked too recent to be a person who died in 1849, which was actually almost the infancy of photography. Okay, well, let's go to the statue, the memorial statue of this fantastic general, old blood and guts himself, General George S. Patton Jr. Okay, follow me. Thank you.